there's so much more to Maharashtrian food than just vada pav, although this is nice and hot and there's lots of yummy food in this video. Welcome to Sugar Spice Nights. My name is Shweta and in this video, I'm in Thane. I'm at a place recommended to me by a friend of mine who's also here shooting with me. And this is a place called Khawaiye. One look at the menu here and you will be royally confused as to what to eat. This is a proper Maharashtrian menu that I'm seeing here, and my friend just described a modak with ghee dripping on it, which I'm pretty sure I'm going to have by the end of this meal. There is pohe, there is shira, there is upma, but one thing that both of us settled on was alu vadi and kothimbir vadi. Drooling all along when I was seeing those shots of them getting fried and stuff. So the first thing I'm going to be trying out is the alu vadi. Alu vadi in Gujarati food, also known as patra, and it's nice and warm. And it's been a while that I've like had freshly fried alu vadi. So here is the first bite. Patra almost has like a sweetish aftertaste. This one is not that sweet, but this is feeling so good. This is made with colocasia leaves, aadu, that's the aadu patta. I just had one bite with the chutney and the chutney is really garlicky. I personally love it. It's just amping up the whole flavor and feel of this. Normally I'm used to the kothimbir vadi looking slightly different, but here's looking very, very similar to the alu vadi. Now feeling a little bit crunchier. I don't know if that's the right word, but it's feeling like it's got more of a texture. It's got a very sharp, almost slightly borderline bitter flavor, but it's feeling very tasty. This and the chutney is going to be amazing. This chutney is not spicy, so I'm like taking an extra generous amount. There's a hint of coconut also in the chutney. I think it's just mega flavorful. So here we have a new kind of chutney. Panch Amrut chutney. This looks like a beautifully tempered chutney. Like I can see mustard. Oh my god. This is a sweet chutney. So I love it already. Flavor of peanut immediately hits you. It's tempered with curry leaves and mustard. And it's got a sweet flavor, sweet and sour flavor actually. It comes from imli or tamarind and jaggery.
Peanuts, coconut, the chutney flavor, the alu vadi, all crushing together and exploding inside is really good. Yeah. So this is a Farari misal. So it's basically sabudana khichdi with spiced up peanut milk and Farari chuda. So that's like Farari namkeen that you eat on like upwas of on the days of fasting, and it's got like a very good texture of the chivi sabudana, the spiced up peanut milk, and the crunchiness of the Farari namkeen, and it's kind of hot, little spicy.
You know what has attracted me the most? Call me a glutton, but whatever, all of the potato salli on top, that is what has attracted me. Nothing like I've ever tasted before. It's so much texture. So the potato bits on top are crunchy, peanut is crunchy, then the usar itself is warm and comforting, and you get like this amazing flavor of cumin from it and curry leaves, and there's that hint of chili. This is very, very nice. Like, I've never tried this before, but I definitely recommend you to try this. It's a fasting special, it's an upvas special, but try it just like that as well. So I did go ahead and order one vada pav in spite of everything else that I'm eating, because I just had to try a vada pav here to see like how good, how different it is. And trust me, you guys, it is amazing. So here the vada pav actually has that green chutney, which the same one that they gave with the aloo vadi and the kothimbir vadi. Little bit of cut onion in it, which I found a little odd in the beginning. But then once I had a bite, got that bit of onion, I realized that this is good. When this came, it was piping hot. And that first bite that I had was so enjoyable. Pitla bhakri and there is bharleli wangi. I actually have two types of bhakris here. One is jwari chi bhakri and I have tandura chi bhakri, which is rice bhakri. So first I'm starting with the rice bhakri and the bharli wangi. The bharli wangi is looking stunning, if I can say so. Flavorful to a different level. It's not spicy. When I saw the gravy, I thought it would be really, really spicy. And normally when I've eaten bharli wangi, I found it very spicy, but this one is not. And you can actually get the flavor of the brinjal while having. It's not like all gravy. It's feeling great. And there are quite a few pieces of brinjal in it. Now I'm trying the pitla bhakri. And pitla is basically made with gram flour or besan. And it's tempered with cumin seeds, mustard seeds, chilies, and it's topped with a little bit of shredded coconut. It's one of those soul-satisfying meals. And this and jowar bhakri is like a match made in heaven. I think the first thing that hits you is that flavor of garlic. It's intense because it's such a lot. And then that of chilies. I didn't try the thetsa that you get with pitla bhakri. I completely forgot about it, so I'm trying it now. I have no idea how spicy this will be. The thetsa is spicy as I don't know what. I had one bite and I needed to have like a whole glass of water. I cannot handle spicy food, as you guys know. It's made with like chilies, proper chilies. It's got some garlic. It's tempered with mustard. Modak. This is ukdi se modak, and we put additional soup on it, additional ghee. Ukdi se means steamed, and inside, I think this is nariyal. What do you think, Piyush?
It's coconut and jaggery.
Coconut and jaggery. Look at that. How gorgeous does that look? As per instructions, I will mash it up and enjoy the first bite. Oh, ukdi che modak. Let me just tell you guys a secret. I have absolutely no place in my stomach. Looking at this, there's like a little bit of hunger which has come back. I can't speak. The coconut and jaggery mixture is a lot. Like many a times it happens in the modak that you're just, you know, feeling the steam part is more and the stuffing is really less, but here it's not like that. And the ghee on top makes all the difference. So these are almost become like, just they completely vanish in your mouth, if I can say so.
Modak is like the most traditional dessert a person can have in Maharashtra at a point. So it's kind of a momo if you have to. But again, this is supposed to be like Ganpati's most favorite thing, is what we have been told as a Marathi child. First of all, it's healthy, it's gluten free, and it's sugar free. Before the taste of the modak, the taste of the ghee hits you first with the aroma. So you're kind of mentally ready what you're diving into. And then it's a smooth journey out of that.
like that smooth journey path.
Yeah. Any place that serves modak, you know that it's kind of at a point authentic place, and they have a good kitchen if they're serving modak, because it's kind of difficult to make. I mean, not everybody has it, so yeah.
Now this is one thing that is very, very unique to this place, and I have never tried or seen it before, but there are three different types of ice cream. So one was modak ice cream, one was a moti chur laddu ice cream, and the third one is here is a puran podi ice cream. Now I would have, I think, tried the modak ice cream, but because I had modak just now, I didn't want to chedo that again. But I'm trying the puran podi ice cream, and never tried this before. It's looking only very, very unique. So here's the first bite. Oh my god, this is like eating cold puran podi. So this ice cream actually has bits of puran podi, like I told you earlier, and it's made without sugar. It's made only in jaggery, which is what I love about it. So it's perfect for anybody who's looking for a sugar-free dessert. Normally I would have thought something like this is a little bit gimmicky, but it's absolutely not. When in a Maharashtrian place as authentic as this, you have to try puran podi ice cream. It is actually puran podi, which is split up into pieces, like almost like scrambled into pieces, and then mixed with condensed milk, and then it's set in the form of an ice cream, which is why you see so many puran podi bits in it. And they also add some cardamom powder, which gives it that additional flavor. So he is like an ace videographer, photographer in weddings, in the blogger space, and I am so obliged that he's actually working with me on this one.
Okay, I feel weird.
I'm going to leave a link to his Instagram for you guys to check out his work, and also his YouTube channel in the description bar below.
Yeah.
So do check that out. Hawaii actually means foodie in Marathi. So if you are a foodie, you are a Khawaiye, then definitely come here and enjoy the food. And I hope you guys enjoyed my first ever food video from Thane. And I had a great time, and I'm so thankful to Piyush for actually helping me shoot this video, coming here with me, being patient, and just making me try all the right things. And I hope you guys like the way this video turned out. Special support for Piyush, because he helped me shoot this. So make sure you give it that like, share it with your friends and family, and subscribe to my channel. And I'm going to leave the details of Khawaiye in the description box below. So do check that out and come here and try out your food. That is really it. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.